I'm a dude playing a dude disguised as another dude.
Hello, collectors, and welcome to the Discount Action Figure Dude. I am your host, Christopher, and we are still, for the final time, at our Hall of Armor, which, of course, as we mentioned before, features our fancy store-bought Halls of Armor and our very personal, homemade Halls of Armor, with this time featuring, as you can plainly see, some War Machines. While Iron Man is my main man, War Machine is my number one dude. I should show you real quick a t-shirt that my little sister bought me just a week ago. Angle up, angle up, angle up, angle up. Thank you, Courtney, for the t-shirt from my little sister. Angle down, angle down, angle down. And if we are surrounded by War Machines, it stands to reason that we are here to check out a War Machine. A Marvel Legends, Marvel's War Machine. We got this at GameStop for, I think it was 5% off for being a GameStop Pro and another 20% off, which made the figure around $19 as opposed to the debilitating price of $24.99. This is the back of the box, side of the box, a little artwork. So let's say you cut this bitch open. And here goes Colonel James Rhodes out of his wax paper prison, standing with us with all of his accessories, of which he has some interesting ones, I must admit. Those are quite fascinating things he has with him. Looking very glossy, looking very, very metallic, and also looking very good. I like the way this guy looks, at least to the naked eye. But hey, let's say we take a closer look at Marvel's War Machine. So this is definitely a different kind of War Machine that I'm used to, but I will admit that I do like the way this guy looks. I love the way the simple colors. He has two colors, black and I don't know what you would call that, a turquoise gunmetal. I am not sure, but I do like the way they pop off of this figure. The lights help too, but I mentioned before that the lighting made some not so great looking Iron Man that I did recently look good. This one doesn't need help. He just looks good the way that he is. As you can see, he comes with the typical Iron Man blast effect. The good thing about getting these is that at least they seem to make them in various colors. So now we have all kinds of different colors for these things for your various Iron Man. You know, his articulation is fairly typical for your Iron Man figures. This guy's joints seem to be a little on the stiff side, but you know, as long as he can strike a flight pose, it would be nice if he could move his head up a little bit better. But you know, what are you gonna do? Head movement is kind of important for a flying character, guys. Just throwing that out there. But let's take a quick look at some of these other really fancy accessories that this cat comes with. Now, I'm not quite sure what's happening here, but I do like the way it looks. I guess he's going supernova. Can't be a good thing. That's a pretty cool accessory, and it's one that I've never seen before. I can't speak for you. Maybe you've seen it before. But it is a new accessory that I've never seen before. Thank you, Hasbro Marvel Legends team, for that. I like that. That's nice. Oh, yeah. I might have to put him on the, I mean, so he's definitely going on my Iron Man shelf. But he may go looking like this. I like that. Not quite sure what's going on here either. But I like the way it looks. So if we peg in another blast effect, plug in this thing again. Again, I'm not quite sure what's going on here with War Machine. I don't know if this is a good thing or a bad thing, but it's a cool looking thing. I'll say that. Yeah, I like the way that this guy looks, especially with these fancy new effects that he has. But then I am partial to War Machine. Now, one last thing before we render value judgment on this thing. Let's see if I could pop off. It looks too big. So, like, here goes our deluxe James Rhodes. Next to our Marvel's War Machine. I am going to take the head off of this guy and put it on that guy, but it looks like it's going to be too big. It just looks too big to me, but you won't know until you give it a shot. Let's see what's happening here. And that looks completely ridiculous. That looks totally ridiculous. But you gotta at least give it a shot. So what kind of value do we assign to this Marvel's War Machine? I like him. I like the guy. I'm pretty sure that most of this that we're looking at is molded plastic. Probably no paint, but every once in a while, it looks good just the way that it is. And this is a figure that looks fantastic. And because he's a James Rhodes, and because he looks so good, and despite the fact he's probably a little bit on the pricey side at $25, even though we paid less than that, clearly. Just to own the figure itself has some value, and in that case, War Machine is a pretty good value.